Hello and welcome, viewers and subscribers of ABG News. My name is Mwalisi, the son of Nube, and I decided we have to talk a bit about the said developments that are happening in Zimbabwe in as far as the judicialization of elections is concerned. You will know that there are about at least two court cases in which some candidates that passed the nominations to contest the elections that are coming next month are concerned. The first one, and probably the most talked about one, has been the issue regarding former Minister of Youth and former Zanu PF Commissar, Mr. Xavier Kasukwere, who is intending to contest as one of the presidential nominees in Zimbabwe, as one of the presidential candidates, rather, in the coming elections, which are slated for the 23rd of August this year, which is next month, about 26 days from now. You'll know that he submitted his nomination papers, or he sent someone to submit on his behalf, because he's been out of the country for some months. So he sent someone, his representatives, to go and submit his papers so that he can stand as an independent candidate in the presidential race. But what happened is that there is a man who then challenged Kasukwere's acceptance by the nomination court. His candidature was accepted by the nomination court, and he was one of the people that appeared in the gazetted list of nominees, or of candidates rather, for the presidential race. But somebody by the name, I think it's Love Day Mangwana, then decided that there was a loophole to manipulate, and he took this matter to court to challenge the acceptance of Kasukwere's papers by the Zimbabwe Electoral Commission. So that case was taken to court, to the High Court. The High Court ruled a week or so ago against Kasukwere's acceptance to stand as a presidential candidate. So it barred him from continuing to stand on the 23rd of August. But Kasukwere then appealed this court ruling. Yesterday, the matter was taken to an appeal hearing. And today, just on Friday morning, the news that we got is that the earlier decision by the High Court has been upheld, which means that Mr. Xavier Kasukwere has been barred from standing in the presidential race. His lawyers and his representatives this morning promised that they would take the case further. They're going to appeal the loss of the appeal. You'll know that also this Mr. Mangwana guy also tried to force, using the courts, of course, the Zimbabwe Electoral Commission to publish the ballot paper without the face and candidature of Xavier Kasukwere. But he lost that case. So Kasukwere won that particular case. But he has now been barred by the courts. But his representatives and his lawyers are saying that they're going to take it further. They are consulting on what else to do, but they're going to go back to the court to challenge this loss of their appeal. So that is the first case. The second case regards at least 12 candidates from Bulawayo, who are members of the Citizens Coalition for Change, which is being led by Advocate Nelson Chamisa. The challenge that was taken to court again was that these 12 candidates submitted their papers very late after the closure, after the close of the nomination court, and this case was taken to court. The said ruling again is that they have been barred from standing as parliamentary candidates. There are also some council candidates. There are also as well some Senate candidates and some proportional representation candidates that will automatically be barred from standing based on this court ruling. And we also hear that in Mutare, another court case is going to be held again or listened to, where CCC candidates again are alleged to have submitted their papers very late, and the fear now is that the loss by Kasukwere of his appeal is going to be a telling development in the sense that it is likely that these CCC candidates are also going to lose their appeal. This is something that we don't wish for, but the telltale signs are already there, and it's highly likely that if they lose these court cases, this trend is going to continue, because there are a number of areas, including much south, where we are told that CCC submitted their papers to the nomination court late, after the close of the nominations, after the close of the court sitting. So this is going to be a big blow to the fight for democracy in Zimbabwe, because we believe that once the names have been gazetted, it is a travesty of electoral laws. It is a travesty of the fight for democracy for them to then be scratched based on some court challenges, which many of them are frivolous, and they're coming from ZANU-PF. We would know that although the race is said to be between ZANU-PF and CCC, it is not only ZANU-PF and CCC that are contesting. And for us to then see one particular party being the one that is concerned, running around, challenging the nomination of certain party candidates, it already shows that this election is not going to be free and fair. And we're talking here about a party which has been accused of capturing almost everything, including these same courts that are ruling against the opposition. But now, is this all lost? I don't think it is all lost, because although it is a sad blow to CCC, we believe that there is a way that the fight for democracy can be salvaged, because we know that especially in the urban centers where these CCC candidates are being flushed out, CCC already has a majority in those areas. This is the stranglehold of the opposition. So how do we salvage this? My idea or my belief is that if CCC loses these appeals, they shouldn't give up, they shouldn't boycott the elections, because this is what exactly ZANU-PF wants. They want to push the opposition to a corner, so that at the end of the day, ZANU-PF wins this seat uncontested. But CCC can enhance the fight for democracy by saying, okay, you've managed to flush us out, but we're not going to give this to you on a silver platter, by then rallying behind either independent candidates that are standing in those particular constituencies, or choosing to go into an alliance with a particular party. We know that there are other parties that are contesting in those areas, and there is no way that ZANU-PF can win, especially in Bulawayo, if CCC publicly rallies behind a certain party. For example, there is ZAPU, there is DOP, there is UZA, they are independent candidates there. But also, these other parties, these so-called Smolanyana parties, which will be standing there, should also pay back CCC by rallying behind the presidential candidature of Advocate Nelson Chamisa. And it's going to be a win-win situation for the opposition in Zimbabwe. This is likely to be the beginning, if it happens, it's going to be the beginning of an opposition alliance against a party that has misgoverned Zimbabwe for so long, a party that has driven Zimbabwe down the drain for so long, which is ZANU-PF. I believe this is workable, and my appeal to CCC and these other parties is that they need now to not throw their hands in the air, but they need to salvage whatever is remaining of the fight for democracy, or of the chance to fight for democracy, by uniting against this monster which we're all seeing blocking every effort to try and rebuild Zimbabwe. So thank you very much. This is what I had for you this Friday. Please don't forget to subscribe to this channel, like this video and share it. But also, if you have your own views, if you have your own ideas as to how this fight for democracy can be salvaged, we only have 26 days, which means that if the court cases are lost forever, we don't have any other way that CCC can continue to stand in those particular seats. So it will be best for them to reach a decision now and go around as they continue to campaign, but also campaign for those particular candidates or particular parties in those specific areas where they would have reached this kind of an alliance or this kind of a coalition, rather, so that people know that when they go to these particular areas, they are going to vote so and so.